set up recruiting stages and categories. In this video, we will show you how to set up your recruiting stages and categories. This allows you to create a recruiting process tailored to your company's specific needs. Creating different stages and categories will allow you to build different recruiting paths for different positions, based on your company's needs and interview process. Thanks to this, you can build a tailored application process. You can see how many candidates are in each recruiting stage at any given time and identify candidates who have been in the same one for too long. As a result, the recruiting process will be faster and more efficient. Predefined stages. Recruiting stages represent the different steps in the recruiting process. You can now find existing and create new ones by clicking on Settings, Recruiting, Stages. There are 5 predefined stages already created: unassigned, rejected, withdrawn, offer, and hired. You cannot edit or delete them. All candidates who haven't been assigned to a stage will appear in the unassigned one. All rejected candidates will be automatically assigned to the rejected stage. And those who have withdrawn their application will be moved to the withdrawn one. If you've sent an offer to a candidate, you can manually move them to the offer stage, but they won't go there automatically. And all candidates who have accepted your offer are assigned to the hired one and are automatically added to Personio as new hires. In addition to the predefined stages, you can create custom ones to personalize your recruiting process. Step 1. Create custom stages. You can decide what custom stages to create based on your recruiting process for the positions that need to be filled. To begin with, go to Settings, Recruiting, click Stages, and then Add New Recruiting Stage. Type a unique name for it and click Save. In the newly created card, select the duration of the stage. Select Unlimited if you want to allow the candidate to remain in this recruiting step without being flagged. Select Limited if you want the candidate to be flagged if they remain in it for longer than the days you've allocated. If the candidate exceeds the amount selected, they will be flagged in the application list. However, no notifications will be sent to either you or the candidate. Select a color for better distinction and click Apply Changes. The newly created stage will appear at the bottom of the list. You can drag and drop it to move to the desired position. You can edit or delete them at any time. To do this, click on the 3 dots in the upper right corner and then click Delete. If there are any candidates in a deleted stage, they will be moved to the unassigned one. To edit the title, click on the 3 dots and then Edit Stage Title. To edit the duration and color, add the new values and click Apply Changes. Once you've created all the stages you need, you can add them to new or existing categories. You can always create new ones later on if needed. Step 2. Create and configure recruiting categories. Recruiting categories allow you to organize and map different recruiting processes. You can structure your categories according to different criteria. For example, by job type, by office, or by department. To create a new category, go to Settings, Recruiting, and click on Categories. Click Add New Recruiting Category and give it a name. Select the recruiting stages you want to include in it. You can drag and drop them to change their order. You can send automated responses to all candidates who have applied for a position. To do this, select which candidates will receive the automated response: those who have applied via email or Personio's application module, or all of them. Then, select a previously created template under Autoresponder. Choose the email signature of an employee as a signature for Autoresponder. You can remind the signees to add a signature in their personal settings. Click Apply Changes. Congratulations! You have now created your very own stages and categories and personalized your recruiting process.